safercigs.co.uk. Sponsors are the Haze Hour.
It's a bit abrupt.
Well, hello, 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 hello. I would, that's, hello, hello. Yeah, it's Thursday. It is the 19th of December. Is it five or six more sleeps until the man comes down the chimney? Is it five or six more sleeps?
I don't know. All I know is that I'm down in the Christmas shopping, yes.
That would make two of us. Are you working it out? Sleep on the 19th, sleep on the 20th,
well, it's six
sleep on the 21st.
If you count the night, isn't it?
You've lost us down at 19th sleep, 20th sleep, 21st sleep, 22nd sleep, 23rd sleep, sleep on the 24th.
Six.
Then go to the pub and stop there on the 25th. It's cancelled. Yes.
Cancelled.
Good evening, viewers. It's lovely to see you out there. We are in festive mood tonight. Well, kind of, at any rate. There's one of the four of us who's dressed in a festive mood.
I was. Until I dribbled juice all down us.
Right.
I am not festive no more.
Okay.
You need a waterproof apron, Chris.
Need something.
Bear in mind, she's not that far up the road. See, if something wrong, she's going to come down and clip you, you know that?
Yes, I better be careful.
I just thought I'd warn you. We are joined, we have, the terrible trio, Kat, Keith and myself, as ever was. Kat in slightly different monitor tonight for the simple reason that the PC's thrown a happy sketch and being a Mac man, I don't know how to fix it. I'll sort that out later. And in the other Mac, we have another Mac man here. This is Andy Sutton, as ever was, from down there in Bristol. How are you doing, Andy? All right, mate?
I'm very well, thank you very much. It's nice to be here tonight.
Goodly Goodingtons. How are you doing? What's the weather doing?
It's cold, it's clear, and it's finished raining for the day.
Are you sure?
Well, you can never be sure about these things, but, you know, I hope so.
Well, we can but hope. We can indeed but hope. Tonight, I thought what I would do would be to take a look over the last year at some of the highs, one particularly low, and this is all in the way of not talking about political action, but we do need to be talking a little bit about what's going on because we've got an expert in television in with us tonight, which is one of the reasons that Andy's here. And that'll all be coming up after the date. Oh, pardon me. It's
better out than in.
I'm full of the Christmas spirit, but it's trying to get back out.
With Kate, yes.
Yes. Yeah. Look at Chris's face. She's so happy.
Aren't I just... Oh, oh, oh.
We've got... It's Ebenezer Cat tonight with us. It'll all be good. I take it you don't need to join in on the titles bit then, Chris, if you don't really want to. Ladies and gentlemen, hello, good evening, and welcome to
the Haze Hour.
Yes, indeed, it is the Haze Hour. Can I just please make a plea into chat? Please don't PM Chris while we're on air, because she was in a festive mood. She's slowly becoming less festive. There's language coming out here, I'm telling you.
Would that be PM tension?
Oh, God.
I'll get my coat.
You do that, Bunny. Do that. Right, look.
Bunny lad.
As you may well be aware, he said, move your camera to, as you may well be aware, on the 11th of January, there are little mini vape meets going on all over the place. And because it's very difficult to find locations in city centres and what have you to be able to guide people to, we came to the conclusion last night in VT Talk, that it might be a good idea if we used well-known landmarks, like, for instance, BBC Studios, to congregate outside of. And it's one of those things with it being in early January, you know, on a Saturday morning at 11 o'clock. Of course, a lot of people will have their families with them. As you might expect, there's nothing, whatever, wrong with that. Because it's kind of a family-friendly endeavour that we're taking part in. But I've been wondering about, you know, what could possibly happen if you were, for example, at a BBC studio and there was, I don't know, 50 people there, a lot of whom were vaping, whether, the BBC might take an interest. And as luck would have it, Andy Sutton, as ever was, understands the BBC. So just as a little bit of background, what happens at the BBC on a Saturday, Andy? Because we haven't rehearsed this, honest.
Not at all. The newsrooms are operating. They're pretty much 24/7. They're staffed 24/7. On a Saturday, there's going to be reduced staff at the site. The only staff, pretty much, who are going to be working are going to be the news department.
Mm-hmm.
So, proximity to the BBC, and if security see something going on outside, they've got to report it to somebody, and then that could get to the news department. In theory.
So there's a likelihood then that, you know, somebody could come out and say, "Excuse me, what's going on?"
Exactly. And if that were to happen, that's the point that the person with the statement would say the reason why they're there, and then that would get passed on. That piece of paper would then get passed to the newsroom, which has got all the details of what's going on, and a crew that is ready and able to shoot at the drop of a story would hopefully appear out of the back gate.
Oh.
Well, isn't that interesting?
That's fascinating.
Be an interesting byproduct of people meeting together. Not as a demo or a picket or a protest or anything like that, just meeting together outside a particularly well-known landmark like a BBC studio or a German television studio or a Dutch television studio or
so
a
is
French
this this new multi-million pound place that we paid for that we're talking about? Is it the...
They're all over, they're up and down the country. I mean, we've got one in Newcastle. There's one in Middlesbrough.
Yes, but not like this palatial place that they've just completed.
Where's that?
Well, isn't it in London? Some...
Oh!
Yeah, the World News Centre.
Yes,
the
there
what?
You are.
It's basically a large open plan office with the newsroom sort of in front of it, so you can always see that it's a hub of world news.
Oh, right, the one that has the track going around it and stuff like
that's
that.
That's the one.
All the cameras.
So I will say that if a group were to congregate outside the BBC or any other news gathering institution, if they had reason to sing a song or make a noise, then that would be all the more reason to feature something like that.
Yes, and I mean, at this time of the year, community carol singing and
festive
songs.
Yes.
You know.
No carol singing. You know what happens? People pretend they're out if you do that.
You see,
outside.
Here we have the sensible voice of Ebenezer Cat.
The whole news department decides that they're out.
Exactly right.
Say it's going to cost us money. I ain't going out there.
Festive carols outside the beat, right?
Well, on January the 11th, it wouldn't be that, would it? But it could be. It could be.
Of course, yeah.
It could
be. I think it was a bunch of drunks. Let's not do the carols.
Not carols. not something appropriate for January.
The weather outside
is frightful. And McCarvin's not delightful.
Well, there's one carol or two in the bleak midwinter.
Yes, you could do that. So, Andy, just let's sum this up. How, these mini vape meets that have got nothing whatever to do with people trying to garner any attention, just sum up from first principles what might possibly happen then. Whoops.
Well, you would turn, the people would be outside, there'd be a group of people making a noise, and you know, a unified reason for being there, all vaping, and a news crew would arrive. They would then film what was going on, and then they would go and find someone within that group to talk to. They would be asked questions off camera first to establish that they are a good contributor.
Erudite.
Yes, they can string a sentence together.
In other words, they're a bullshit. Yes.
Absolutely. And then it would go from there. And then the cameras would get some shots of what was going on, you know, whether it be electronic cigarettes or whatever the reason the group was there to do, whether, mm-hmm. you know. And it would go from there. And then that person would be interviewed, and then they'd go around and get what's called vox pops from the people in the crowd. And they'd probably also get passers-by to comment on what was going on. So that could be quite interesting as well.
Yes. I probably just need, for the benefit of chat, and for those of you watching on video on demand, you won't have seen this, but Gillis, people will be vaping, not gaping, and very boring, they'll be vaping, not vamping. And can I just say that autocorrect, if the EU wants to ban anything, can you please make it bloody autocorrect? Because it's a heap of shit.
Yeah. The times that I've typed something in and I'm suddenly wearing a cape.
Yes, for I too am a caper. Are you a gaper, Chris, or a caper?
I'm a giggler at the moment. I'm laughing at some of the suggested songs in chat.
Oh, good.
I love Alan Fletcher's "A Vape in a Manger."
Oh, I like that. Christmassy. That's good. Christmassy. Yes.
And let it vape. Let it be. Some good.
Oh, that's
hey, did you hear? I didn't realise you would sing, Mrs.
That talent. Great,
and so it goes on. There's some canny ones. They're really funny tonight, aren't they?
Well, they are. Let it be. They're a good lot. I mean, oh, well, yeah. Because this jant he made is frightful. But my VTR is delightful. And I clear 30S. I'll say yes.
Have you just made that up as you go along?
On the spot as you go along.
And you're not
That's talent.
Is that? Yes. So AliCat 2479 has just said, and if you can only get a small group of vapers together, each could ask their family and friends to come along because it affects absolutely everybody. Family day out. And
exactly.
And of course, having done a couple of hours outside the Beeb, then, gentlemen, you can take your ladies shopping. Or alternatively, you can send them shopping while you stood outside the Beeb. It's a win-win situation. It doesn't matter which direction you come at it from. And Frat Alexod has come up with a title of a song called Sacrilegious Scorn from Dimmu Borgir, as being a particularly good piece of music for a certain person whose name shall not cross my lips during the course of the evening. Those of you in chat know who it is. Those of you watching on video demand, you can guess. Shall we do something a bit of... Right, shall we move into...
Oh, dear.
Oh.
What's happened, Chris?
It's done it again.
Has it dumped on you?
Yes.
Where's it come from?
I wish I knew, but I know where it went.
What?
I'm tempted to ask whether you can zoom your camera out so I can see the stains, but I know that would be ungentlemanly, so I won't.
I tell you, if those facts were correct about how much nicotine would kill you, your books.
You'd be dead by now.
Your books, hear it? Never mind, carry on. Malik Bannett, exactly.
Yes. Leanna Lawless says she has nobody but a fat old married man, not hers, to bring. I am tempted to ask, but I'm not going to. For I fear the answer. I fear the answer. I think Leanna Lawless's maiden name might have been Fritzel.
Right, okay, I'm gonna fall for it. Schnitzel? Why Schnitzel?
Fritzel.
Fritzel.
As in Joseph Fritzel. I think her maiden name must have been Fritzel. She's got a fat old married man, but not hers.
Oh.
So I think she's been keeping them down in the basement. And apparently, old git is considering that your drips are going to make for a wet T-shirt live on VTTV, Chris.
Already has.
Oh, dear.
Shut up, Sutton.
I was just thinking, it's good. It's good that mine's not leaking then.
Shut up, Sutton.
Yes. I'm just going to say this, Bob. I think you might be in dire danger next time you even cut meat. And no, you're not allowed to try and spill your pint over her. That would just be wrong. Completely wrong. It looks as though Sav's been involved as well, but I'm saying nout. I'm not saying a word because I know how much trouble I can get into. Tell you what, I'll play in the trailer of stuff that comes up over the next week and then we'll get started on the rest of the e-cigarette stuff. We'll be back in just a sec. There you go, that's what comes up most weeks on vaportrails.tv, which is all good stuff. And while that was playing out, I was reading chat, and Lena Marie Popper Torsen apparently is going to be getting 3.5 million followers on Twitter for where she can put her feet, behind her legs. Behind her head, rather.
Was she an ostrich?
You can't put your feet behind your legs, but apparently she can get hers behind her head. So she's going to get a lot of followers on Twitter and possibly a lot of requests on YouTube. She said she can't type with them. Trust me on this one. If you can get them behind your head, you have no need to type with them.
I've got a question. If your knees bent the other way, what would chairs look like?
Oh.
If your knees bent the other way,
what would chairs look like? They'd still look the same, you daft bugger. You'd just look stupid sitting in them. The good thing about it is, of course, you wouldn't need to buy nail clippers. You could just chew them off.
Oh, God.
Bit of video.
Well, hello. Following that virtuosic piece of musical playing, all right, it's Smule on the iPad. Here to talk about this here thing here.
And that was a year ago.
Dear, dear.
That was a year ago. It was actually filmed on the 3rd of December 2012, which leads me nicely into where I want to go for the rest of the night. Looking back over the year, finding out what people's favourite devices and juices and battery units and God knows what else has been. And I'm going to play in as well little bits of video of some of the from this year as well. But that'll be after the adverts, which are coming in now. So don't go anywhere. We'll be back in a couple of minutes.
Safer6.co.uk sponsors are the Haze Hour.
And we are back in the room. So yes, it's been, again, reading through chat while all this was going on, and a question's come up. What tank is big and uses silica or cotton and is sturdy? Chris had an answer straight away. Chris?
None of them.
There you go.
I thought that was a joke out of a Christmas cracker.
Yeah, sturdy. Yes, I tell you what, Steffi Dampfkex has said her best thing from 2013 is she started vaping. There you go.
Woo!
And apparently MG Jones says you can now get a Bobo Atty. I didn't know that.
Back to Bobo.
A Bobo Atty. DJ Bobo, I love the idea of that. Dazzle, love that. Seriously, no joke.
That's the chain, isn't it?
I've no idea.
The Bobo's still missing, isn't it?
Bobo, yes. Yes, he's... Well, he hasn't been seen hiding hair off, or she hasn't been seen
That was one of the tragic highlights of the year, wasn't it?
Absolutely. Well, do you want a real tragic highlight?
Yes.
Here we go. Right at the beginning of the year in February, I was inveigled into taking a look at a piece of kit. And I've cut this into two bits. Here's the first bit.
Well, hello. And I'm here in the Looking At It In Close-Up studio to have a look at the Janti MID1, the MID1 from Janti, the very latest piece. You may recall last week we looked at it very, very quickly just to see what it was all about. This week it's a little more in-depth to show you how you use it. Since last I spoke to you, the manual has arrived, and in actual fact what you need to do is to register on the Janti MID forum, and then you get to download all of the various different manuals and pieces of software, which is exactly what I've done. read through them, and I'm going to try and do this from memory, but you may see slight breaks where I need to refer back to the manual. But what makes the mid? Well, let's have a look and see. And the mid, basically, what we're talking about here is a joystick-driven piece of kit. And the joystick itself here is very, very neat. Moves very simply. As you'll be able to see, the movement is not massive. Moves in four directions and presses down as well. And then underneath that is probably the really important part. Now I'm having to come from the mouthpiece end down over to be able to show you how this all comes together, for the simple reason that if you work it from the other end as if you were holding it, when you go to actually do anything, and I'll use my index finger, you cover up the little LED, so you can't really see what's going on. So I'm going to come from the mouthpiece end here to try and show you how this all works. Right, so pressing the fire button, we have a red LED, and the red LED tells me that I am in my number one profile. To change the profile on the fly, we move the little joystick three times to the right quite quickly. One, two, three. And you will see that we get a different coloured LED flashing away. This time it's purple. That's what I've set it to so that I can understand what's going on. And if I now move the joystick to the right.
Now those of you that were there when we did that, when we played that in, will recall that it went on for quite a considerable period of time. But I've just realised, and Chris has just reminded, we're getting in practice for a couple of years' time. Can I please ask you to confirm that you are indeed a vapor? Otherwise we could be promoting e-cigarettes to you, and that could be construed as being illegal in a couple of years' time. And we don't want to do that by any stretch of the imagination. Let's go back to a lot later in that video, and you'll see why this is a... Here it comes.
2.5 ohms is the cartonizer, and that will run everything up to 6 ohms. And on the left hand side tells me how much battery's got left. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. No, it isn't. It's 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 87% roughly is where we're at. What that means is all of the information that you require is at your fingertips. There is one further menu entry that you can use.
Did you see that beautiful piece of skirting around the fact that I couldn't count those numbers? It's a very strange piece of kit. It's
a piece of what?
Sorry,
a piece of kit.
Piece of kit. Actually, no.
I didn't hear you right.
Now. You might actually have heard right. The fact of the matter is, that has been just sat in the box, and it has not been used. That is the Janty mid, and I'm here to tell you, Chris's mishearing of kit is very much closer to the mark. I don't know. I mean, while the video was playing, Keith was sitting there saying, "I don't remember looking at that." We did live. That's how memorable it is. It's one of the most forgettable devices of 2013, and I did
what
see.
Is?
There you go. Have a play with it. Where was I? I did see that somebody actually owned up to having one in chat and nobody else would. A piece of what? Yes, it is a piece of ship.
I mean, the joystick isn't very positive, is it?
It's highly negative.
Wobbles.
I put some batteries in it the other day just to see whether it would still work, because I have virtually nothing else charged. I was going to do a direct comparison between it and the E-mod, because they'll both take the same size batteries.
It even looks depressing, doesn't it? It
doesn't look very good.
What battery does it take?
It'll take a 16650 or two 13340s. 16340s, not 13340s. You know the little red ones you pay £8 each for and then discover they'll not work for anything worth in anything else. Well, you know, I mean, nice idea, really, really badly executed. And fact of the matter is, if Keith was to top pocket that one, I would not care.
So do they still make them?
Oh, aye, and some daft buggers still buy them. But nobody that'll own up in chat. Yes. Max Height, who is Utash's brother and Pilosh's brother, Max Height, says, top pocket, Dave, let him have that one. You wouldn't like it, Keith.
No, no. I've already got a black one.
I wouldn't do that for you. I wouldn't do that for you. But, when we're talking about that, go on then, Andy. What's been your standout device of 2013?
To be honest, I haven't bought a great deal of kit this year because I've been busy with other things. but the devices that I've sort of relied on, I've got to say, I took it to the mini meet and the knees meet, and the trusty old MVP is never far away. It charges phones. And love it to bits. I haven't got the version 2 yet, but Christmas
version
sales,
two's
January
not so
sales,
good, Andy.
Maybe.
The Switch is a bit stiff.
Say again, Chris?
The version 2, the general consensus is the Switch is a bit stiff.
Yeah, I heard that, and version 1 does everything I need it to do, really. I mean, you know, it's always nice to get a new shiny thing, isn't it? But reliable. The EVIC, of course, is a favourite. It's almost like the mid, but with a screen, isn't it? So you can actually understand what it's doing.
No. It's nothing like a mid with a screen.
Is it not?
No. To begin with, it only uses one battery. It doesn't take stacked batteries.
Oh, yes, of course.
Secondly, the bloody thing works.
Yes.
And thirdly, it's not a pile of shite.
All valid points.
Just thought I'd say that. I thought I'd get that in before Chris did.
Yeah, and on the top of these devices, I've got a RSST.
It's funny you should mention that, Andy.
Yeah.
Because one of my upsides for 2013 is going to be the RSST. I think, could be right in saying, it's one of the most popular Genesis-style atomizers in the length and breadth of the country, if not Europe.
Really? Well, yes. I will say, when I was just using lengths of wire, it wasn't a great success for me. Rebuildables in general, as you might, I went through with my rebuildable diary, and I tried to improve my coiling and wicking skills. And there are very many ways of, with the stainless steel mesh and all that sort of stuff. I went to Clearomizers and stayed there for this year, really, just because of traveling around a lot and convenience. But another thing that I only just recently ordered that has been transforming my vaping experience...
His vaping experience has been transformed, Keith.
It has. Right. It's probably the most invisible thing I can hold up. It's a no-resistance wire.
Oh, a pre-made coil wire.
Yeah, and I got some from stealthvape.co.uk. Mm-hmm. Other vendors are available. And cheap. I got the 50 of them for like £3. And I bought quite a few.
Apparently so. What resistance are they then?
They are 2.2 ohm.
Ohm. And can you wind a micro coil with them?
I haven't tried yet. That's on my Christmas list of things to do when I've got some time off.
Cool.
And I haven't tried cotton wool yet, but I'm excited to.
Andy, get yourself a darning needle, or a bodkin, as Dave calls them.
I do. Yes.
Yeah, one of those is in the kit. But I've been watching the shows, and you've been talking a lot about the squib. Squid?
Squeep. Squip.
Squape.
Yes. Sorry, no. I should have pronounced it like that, of course. Yes, I mean the squape, dear boy. Go. Yes.
Yes. I spent a little while Googling the other night.
You dirty little sod.
Squid, squib. Can't imagine the things that came up.
So you've been sitting on a night in your little back bedroom in the dark Googling your squib.
Yeah.
You squib. Dirty little bugger.
Pretty funny name, that.
What, squib?
Yeah, squib.
It's a funny name for something you can swear at. Well, that's what Chris thinks, don't you, Chris?
Because I watched your cotton wool microcoiling.
Yes.
On catch up.
Mm-hmm.
And you had a delight with it, didn't you?
I'm having an absolute delight. It's positively orgasmic, is my squib. I love it to bits. It's never far away from me. It's the thing that I'm using probably more than anything else at the moment, and I'm trying out all kinds of things at the minute, trying to get my head around various different things. But I love it. You can recoil it and re-wick it in no time flat. And I'm going to say Chris will attest to that, because during the course of you re-wicked and recoiled it, Chris?
I did. Yes, a microcoil.
I was going to say, though,
I have to say I've got an incontinent squib tonight.
Continent.
A what?
An incontinent squib.
It's so
these things happen, you know.
It's so much more polite than what she would have said.
Doesn't
on
it? I've been thinking is, how to put it for quite a while, and that was the best I could come up with.
I'm telling you now, if it had been a private Skype chat, she'd have said, "David's pissing all over."
Yeah, see, it's quite contradictory, though, isn't it? Because you love yours to bits, mm-hmm. and for most of the show, Chris's squape has been in bits.
I love my squib. Don't get me wrong, Andy. It's just not well the night.
Right. Bit of a yeah.
Incontinent night.
Yes.
It's a funny thing. I think I don't know why. I think I just fell upon the right amount of cotton wool, which is posh for cotton wool.
Mm.
Cotton wool. That's what they say in Clayton, isn't it, Chris? Sorry, Cleeding.
Cutting well.
In Cleeding, where they have gardings.
Garding.
Oh, yeah, just go out into the garding. Would you like a cup of tea? Yes, and do take sugar in that. Do you have sugar?
Sugar.
Do you like? Would you like some sugar?
Sugar.
How many spoons full?
No, I think that was one of your funniest demonstrations of the year, that.
What was?
The cotton wool thing.
Really?
Oh, I did. You know, the donkey's tail hanging out of the end. Do you remember?
I don't think I described it thusly, but I guess...
Yes.
I think I've got a fair idea what you mean.
Keith was tickled by your cotton wool.
Yes, that's one way of putting it, aren't I? Yes.
And on on that little bombshell, we'll go to the second look of adverts, I think, because I really need to find out where I've been keeping this donkey's tail. There used to be a cry when I flew model aeroplanes. Is that a donkey on the field, or are you just pleased to see me? I'll go to the adverts. We'll be back in 2 minutes.
Save the Six. Sponsors of the Haze Hour.
Hang on.
Go on then, Chris. Leanna Lawless went, "Wonder if my lighted magnifying gloss will help coiling." And Sav said, "I was so tempted to say, let's hope it helps with your typing, but I didn't."
they type the way they speak, but there you go. So, yes, there you go, back from the adverts, and here we go. Well done. Bad. Leanna Lawless says it's a bad keyboard, and she spelt keyboard correctly, so that's all good. We do it out of love, Leanna. We do it out of love. I didn't blush, did I? No, we're all right then.
Oh, for Pete's sake.
Now what?
The drops are pouring out of the e-vic.
Yeah, they're
in a real mess tonight, isn't she?
I know, you're having
worrying.
A right. You're having a right fart and fart and carry on, Mrs. Woman.
The back of that. Bloody soaking.
It's coming out the bottom. Have you got your coil down below the level of the groove? Get your thingy in, shovel it up a touch. Push it up.
Try that.
Is that not working either?
No, it's not working either, Dave.
I'll come up. I'll come up and sort it out.
I mean, that seems to be fine. I don't know if you can see it there.
Put it flat on, Chris, so I can see across the top between the two screws. There's nothing wrong with that.
You see, it's just incontinent.
It is.
It's now down the sides. And I thought, well, okay, let's be sure you're putting it on the right way to create a vacuum.
Go on, then.
In like that. That it's upside down.
It is. Fully
tight.
I then
get me drip tip while the juice is down there.
Aye.
And then turn it up.
Right.
Has he got O-rings?
It should be all right.
Right, hold it there. See if it drips. That looks all right.
We needed the countdown music then.
Ding 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 ding
ding ding ding
ding ding ding.
I'll just leave it there. 2.3, it says.
Good. Have a draw. What are you vaping at?
3.68 volts, 5.9 watts. So it's pretty low there.
That's very low, aye. Well, it's working, missus.
I know.
Keep it upright, didn't lie it down. Give the vacuum.
I never do. Catalytics are done.
Ah, well, there you are, you see. Is that hi-fi, is it?
Aye.
30 mils of juice a day.
Exactly.
30 mils.
There's nothing wrong with that. Leave it there. Right, we'll see how it goes. If that works by the end.
I'll go back to the trusty trank.
She's a tranker. Yes. Okay. Chat is talking about all kinds of stuff here. Incontinence sounds like you're on holiday. Posh term for a broad. Who said that?
That's a lady, isn't it?
Is 30 mil allowed? No.
Well, it is for the minute, aye. Right. You were on about the RTSTRTTTSTSTTT, Mr. Sutton.
RSTTST. Which I completely forgot the name of when we just about to come. I had a complete blank. But this is running with the cable, with a little bit of mesh around the top, and then one of the pre-made wires, and it's been treating me very well for a couple of days. It's very nice.
I should point out for Lena Marie Potter-Torson, no, it's not the RSTD, it's the RSST, and I did some video on that as well. Have a watch. Well, here it is, the Smok RSST in bits. So let's see if we can pull this thing together. And it's very simple to do. This is the base, and all you need to do is to screw the centre post into the base. Either way up, both ends are the same. So we screw this outside part into there, like that. And then the tank. Now, as you can see, the tank has a centre
I don't know what you would call it, a centre post that goes up the full height of the tank itself. It's plastic, so I would be very, very wary of cinnamon heavy mixes. But that then slides onto the base. Now, the base itself, as you will see, there is a little wee nylon nut in there. So where next? We put the cap on, the deck rather, and again, that screws on to the centre post. Screw it down good and tight. Now, one of the things I want you to notice is that the wick hole here has insulation around it. It's insulated from the rest of the deck. Total insulation there, as you can see by that little black line. Now, what that means is that your wick is never going to touch a negative contact. So then the next bit goes in, and the next bit is the center post with the contact, and the contact is sprung via this washer, so the wire is going to go there between the washer and the top of the screw. So let's put that in and just finger it to get the start. And in fact, you can actually get there totally on finger pressure, should you so desire. And you will note that it peaks out of the bottom, much as you would expect. So you can set that so it's only just, say, poking out, which this one is. And that pretty much is the assembly. So what about witting it? Well,
okay, that was basically how the RSS team went together. And I'm just very wondering how many people sat and spotted all the innuendos that were in there. Is this something you said?
Or was it the wick hole, or was it, is there a flange anywhere near there?
I think you did ask if a wick hole was another name for a flange, and I said in certain circumstances it could be, and then Kat mentioned...
Well, you can't stick your grommet in a flange, you know. And finish off with a screw.
Why did I get a picture of an Aardman animation then?
I've got no idea.
Two fingers.
Yeah, it takes two fingers to get started.
Finger pressure
and finger pressure. Yeah,
I'm just looking at it. Steady.
Does that help you with your putting your RST onto your EVIC by any chance, Andy?
Help me with something.
What?
No, it doesn't work on EVIC. Did it? I must have a loose flange in my connector. There's a bit of moisture in the hole as well.
Probably your two-finger pressure's a little heavy.
Well, I used two-finger pressure when I got the screwdriver out.
Oh,
yeah. Oh, no, look at that. Oh, you've made Kat cry. Yeah.
Try and ban this, you bastards.
Can we just summarise, you know... What?
Don't say no, Kel! Don't say no, Kel!
What have we learned from this, do you think?
Well, hell of a lot.
We need to be careful how we mention things, I think.
Just says carry on vaping.
I just think we need to gird our loins on this one.
Right.
Don't you?
I
think it... I do think it...
You're in control, David.
What do you mean I'm in control?
I'm supposed to be. Yeah.
I'm never in control. No way.
I'll check my incontinence.
Yes. Who's Gertie?
Is it too bad?
Is it all right?
seems to be all right.
You've got no little drops of juice running down the shaft?
No little drops running down the shaft.
Good job, it's past 9 o'clock.
Why does it take you that long to get started, like?
What?
Is this what the EU mean by advertising?
I've got the idea. I have no clue. Right.
Yes.
Just try. Moonlit has posed a very good question. After Entropy has said she's overly lubricated, that's the problem, but let's not go there. Moonlit says he's a bit late with the question, but do we have some sort of easy list of who's meeting at which of Auntie Beebe's houses? I think the various different forums have got threads going left, right and centre. We saw UKV ad, I know AAEC, Fluffy Bunnies has, Plant of the Vapes has. There's loads of the forums have got threads on all about Auntie Beebe's houses and stuff like that. So there's loads of places. Twitter's thick with it. I mean, I was seeing announcements all during the course of the day on Twitter of people going to various different places and putting postcodes down and stuff like that.
I'll also put a link that I found this afternoon that lists, it's an interactive map that you can click on it and it tells you the address of your local news centre.
Oh, that's a brilliant idea.
I've lost that.
That is very good. Castello 2 has said, why has the BBC been so quiet about e-cigs? I wonder why people are meeting outside the BBC, Andy, can you?
I can't think why.
No.
I can't think why.
No. That would be...
When I first thought that there was a story in electronic cigarettes and the people who love them, the people who use them and the people who want them banned, I went to an executive producer at the BBC and said, this is the story. And he said, you haven't really got a story until they're banned. Here we are. So... it's a very interesting, you know, that is the story of the people reacting to it. So let's give them the story.
Yeah, I think that's a damn good point. Talking about stories and stories behind the stories and stuff like that. Yeah. I have another little bit of video here. This has got nothing to do with what's gone on over the last... That's it, we're done with that now. We might bring some more of that in. Because Monday night, of course, there's the Christmas show, isn't it, Chris?
That's right, yeah.
And
Tinder Tip's still going on, but it'll be more of a team talk type show, I would think, you know, where we all get together and just have a bit giggle.
No we talking over the tiles.
All of us.
Yeah. Are there any rules on sobriety?
No.
Oh, good.
Just ban it, I think.
Okay. Fine.
You know, ban sobriety for the night.
I can live with that. Somebody's asked, is there any news from Chris Choi? Yeah, he's still filming. And if I'm to understand, they'll still be filming in early January. I'm looking forward to that all coming up on January the 16th at 7:30 on ITV. All regions, apparently. Which
a half an hour show would probably take... half an hour news show would probably take about 4 or 5 days to edit. So that's probably their cut-off point. But they can obviously be filming the end while they're editing the beginning.
Yes. It's
way around, actually. Oh, I said that way around.
Filming the beginning while they're cutting the end?
No. They could be filming the end while they're cutting the beginning.
All
right. I was just going to ask you how often you cut your end. Was worth a thought. Yes.
Spent the day cutting a recipe about summer pudding today.
Well, that's always good, isn't it? Lena Marie Papatorson's just said, someone has to record this and upload it somewhere, please. I know it's illegal, but still, I so want to say that, but I don't know what it is that she's looking for to be uploaded, because all of the shows we do get uploaded.
They do.
Oh, tinsel your tip on Monday. No, tinsel your tip.
I like that.
Oh, tinsel your tip.
Tinsel your tip.
That's it.
That's nice. Oh, the ITV show, the ITV show will be available on YouTube, trust me. That will. the stuff that was recorded here when he came and did that, that's already up there. But yeah, it'll be up there. Don't you worry. Stuff like that always ends up on YouTube. I don't know how. No idea how. The mighty elves. Elves. It's elves what does it. Yes. Yeah. Paul has said, is there any more coming from Swaff? There is, and it's coming on Saturday. Here is a trailer. So, yes, this is all coming up on Saturday. Well, not all of that, but there's something coming up on Saturday. Andy, tell everybody what.
Yeah, a peek behind the scenes. I shot a whole load of video diaries as I travelled around the country and at various stages. And it's not a really sort of chronological look at Swaff. It's got sort of themed. So this Saturday coming is my sort of, as I get going with it, and you know, I film myself and film the different places that I go to, and the following week gets a little bit more political and goes into that a little bit further, and might have an interview with some of the people that shot it and stuff like that, and what they experienced when they filmed it, because as well as that, in the behind the scenes, one step beyond behind the scenes, I'm working on a lengthy video that will be released, that is coming soon, let's say that.
Okie dokie, that's all good. In chat they're saying we want Dr. Christian on here and we want Viscount Ridley on here. We're trying, aren't we, Chris?
We are. Yes.
We are actually trying to get them both. I'd like to get them both at the same time, but I'm not sure that everybody'd be able to handle that, if I'm to be truthful. entropy. Dear Dr. Christian, I have an embarrassing dripping squib. WhippedUp69 has said, can we help on Twitter, Dave? Yes, you can. Please. Very gently, just invite him to appear on vaportrails.tv. And yeah, that would be brilliant. That's all good. I don't mind. And we'd love to have the pair of them on here at one time or another. And, you know, I'm constantly looking to get good quality guests that get it and have some pull and some clout.
Mm-hmm. Well, Viscount Lord Ridley actually is a vapor.
He is.
Is that Nick Ridley? Nicholas Ridley?
Is it Nicholas?
No,
who?
Matt.
Matthew.
Matt.
Viscount Lord Matt.
Well, that, right, that must be, yes, right.
That's, yes. I know, we move in different circles, Keith.
He is a neighbour of ours.
He lives up near.
That, well, his father was a cabinet minister.
His father died last year.
His father was in Thatcher's cabinet.
Mm. Same guy.
His father died last year.
Yes. So this is
in our neck of the woods.
I mean, sitting listening to what he had to say in the big committee in the Lords, that was just fabulous. That's really, really getting it. Brutalness has said he doesn't know why, but he wants to see Mr. Hunt on here. Trust me, I'd like him on.
God.
You have got no idea the names of people or the number of people that I've invited, aunties that I've invited to come on, and none of them will. Martin McKee is one. Simon Chapman is another. Glantz is another. I've invited all sorts of them to come on, and they won't. Don't ask me why, don't know.
Well, it's that same thing with Swaff as well.
Yes. You're having the same problems, Andy.
Yeah, yeah. they are reluctant to give their side of the story, really. We keep going and we keep trying and we try different avenues, and we had a little bit of success with one of the key players that we often discuss, and that will be on the show on Saturday.
Indeed. I just need to answer a question that's coming just there now from Durham. Durham has said, have any vendors showed any interest in the BBC Meat Gets Togethers, or is it to be left to the customers to ensure they have a living? This is about us. This is the consumers making a noise. If vendors want to turn up as vapers, not as vendors, so no logo up and any of that, that's great. But this is consumers only. That's what it is. The vendors they have their organisations and their behind-the-scenes meetings that are doing what they're doing. But we are consistently aware, and Chris will back me up on this, that the astroturfing thing will be pointed at us like a shot.
Yeah.
And we just don't want that. This is consumers, that's what it's about.
The same sort of vibe as the Brussels balloon job then.
Absolutely, yes. Yeah. Absolutely, yes. That's exactly what it's all about. And as I say, Chris will back me up. I mean, we've been battling this for I don't know how long, haven't we?
Absolutely right, yeah.
I've got to say this as well. Every time I'm thinking about doing something or I'm asked to do something, I talk it over with Chris and we look at all different aspects and how it can be viewed by those who would oppose us. And trust me, there is no better sounding board, because she picks up on things I would miss. And AstroTurf, that's how that'll be seen, or it'll be seen like this, be seen like that, and it's amazing. It's really good. So on this occasion, just to keep that kind of thing completely out of the way, we're all just vapors that are going to be there. No logos, no none of that. Black shirts, we think, is a decent idea. And that's what's going to be happening on the 11th. Brutalness is asking, is there more I can do from my home? Yeah. Get people to go. If you can't make it, for whatever reason, get other people to go in your stead. I would love to think that every BBC television, radio, office, station, whatever, had 50 people having a mini vape meet outside it on Saturday the 11th of January at 11 o'clock for a couple of hours. That would be fabulous, wouldn't it?
Also, can I say as well that obviously the people who are attending, who can attend, get on Twitter and say you're there. Give an idea of how many people are there.
Yeah.
If you've got a camera phone, shoot some video. One person that would be very, very grateful at that.
Who's that, Andy?
I don't know. Somebody.
No idea.
Film. Yeah. And also, if you're at home and you can't go and you see the tweets and find, tweet back and retweet and everything like that, but also get on the phone and phone up the BBC, phone up ITV. And say, I think there's a flash mob of electronic cigarette users outside a news organisation. I'm a vapor and I want to know why they're there.
Do you know that?
Yeah, that's a good idea.
He's clever, isn't he?
That's a good idea.
So it connects it all.
Yes.
Yes.
Connect it all up. That's the way to go. That's the way to go.
Absolutely right. I mean, if you can get it on forums and coordinate that and get as many people to sign up, all the better, so that you have an idea how many you're going to start off with. This is what Nathan's asked me to ask, because he's organising one in Cardiff and would like an idea how many people are going to be there, so that he can let the press know in advance. Well, it's very difficult to do that without getting some names down on paper, you know?
So yeah, the feet get on onto the forums, really important, get names down,
get on Twitter, anything you can.
Yeah.
Yes.
And just get it publicised.
Absolutely right. Absolutely right. I have every confidence that this is going to be fabulous. And as Andy says, if you've got an iPhone or anything that will shoot video, shoot some video. Let's get it all into a central repository, because I'd love to be able to, on the Thursday after or the Wednesday after, cut something together and play it out. Or if Andy's got it, or whoever.
Or even just get it on YouTube and then send the BBC the link and say, what's going on here? Why isn't this being reported? You know, I'm a vapor. They're complaining about it. And my side of the story isn't being reported. And enough people do that, then it becomes a news story, and they become interested in it. which is, I think, the main. I don't think there's any, you know, the, I would like to think there is no restriction on reporting stories about e-cigs. I think that it just needs to represent a noise, and this is a good step towards doing that.
Absolutely right, and chat coming up with all kinds of ideas, and I'm seeing here.
Somebody create a Facebook page, you know, and have people post for the different areas. There's all kinds of things.
Well, if anybody shoots me a link as well, it will go straight onto the SWOF stuff, onto the Facebook page as well. I'm sure Vapor Trails would do the same thing, and it'll just, you know, the community need to know about it, but then the people outside the community, news organisations, your local newspaper, every radio stations, they can all be tweeted links and go, this is happening right now. Get somebody down there. I want to know about it. Why isn't this being reported?
Indeed, indeed.
Disco Des is saying there is a Facebook page. So there you go. There's a start.
Lovely.
Can you tell us the name, Disco Des, please?
Or a link to it. I'm sure we can pick that up and sort it out. Yes, vendors can inform customers in stores. Mark Shaw's reminded me, Marina Yannakadakis has already expressed a desire to go along to hers. So get on to your local supportive MEPs, the Lib Dems, the Conservative MEPs. Right. They're all supportive. Get onto them and see if they want to turn up. I've already tweeted ECR Group and Aldi Group and the Lib Dem UKs. Get onto them. Get them all there. That would be brilliant.
Right. Vapor Splash Mobs.
Vapors.
Okay.
There you go.
Facebook.
Vapors Flash Mobs UK. I'm sure Sav will have a full link and get it up there.
Yes, she's got it.
There you go.
Can I just add something as well? Inviting your MEP, certain parties will see what has happened as a victory and they will want to spin it as a success. The people who are there, the spokesperson, needs to have a counter-argument prepared for that success story. How is it not a success story for the community? What will it do? How will their success be a failure for you? It needs to be boiled down into little sound bites so it can be packaged up and put against what the politicians say.
Indeed, and I would highly recommend Clive Bates's blog for that, for he has every last point addressed. Highly recommend Clive Bates's blog to pick that up. Entropy's asking where his local BBC is. Is the one near Scunthorpe? And if Typhoo put the tea in Britain, who put... Never mind. Andy?
Once this show has finished, I will put the link that I mentioned up onto the SWOF page, and then I'm sure it'll get propagated to other places as well. And that is a very useful clicky map that then just tell you. I think you can type in your postcode as well, and it says what your nearest news centre is.
There you go. So,
but there are main news centres and there are little news centres. The smaller they are, the less staff will be there. Targeting the larger ones is probably a better idea. Like somebody tweeted to me today. I apologise, I can't remember who it was. I got many tweets today. They asked whether Swansea was the same size newsroom as Cardiff. Cardiff is a larger centre, so the newsroom is larger. So therefore, it will have more staff in it, and they will be able to assign more people to it.
Yes, I mean, I know in our area, Newcastle is big, Middlesbrough is big. There is an office in Sunderland, but it's teeny-weeny, so I wouldn't bother with Sunderland. It's Newcastle and Middlesbrough, either side. There's one in Carlisle. I'm pretty sure there's one in Hull, but I beyond that,
the Sheffield. One in Durham, is there?
No. There used to be, but it's gone now.
Right.
They have consolidated the BBC sort of resources.
And in Glasgow, apparently, I think STV used to be on Hope Street. I don't know whether it still is, but apparently it's just a few doors away from the BBC, so it's two birds of one stone there.
Yeah, apparently it's more or less over the street.
Mm-hmm.
So they can get the cameras out of one window and pick it up and go, you know. Today, we found Vapors stood outside the BBC trying to have their cause recognised, and BBC totally ignored it. My name's Hamish McTavish, STV News at 10. There you go. With apologies to every Scot that ever lived. But you know what I mean.
I should hope so.
Yes. Runeir, I don't do BBC English. Have you seen the time, Chris?
Yeah, God, I have.
It's your fault.
Yeah.
Tis what it is.
Have you started yet?
I think, I don't know. Yeah, yeah, the little red button's on.
All right. Rico, Nathan's organising the Cardiff meet. He should be in chat there somewhere.
Great stuff.
Mm. Like I say,
I think it's time to say goodnight, lads.
Good night, lads.
Good night, lads.
Good night, lads.
Good night.
Good night. It's been a great pleasure sharing the last hour and 11 minutes with you. Dave's Tattle Box will be on Sunday. Don't forget to tune in for RY4 Radio right now, where DJ Bobo is spinning the wheels of steel. He's not actually, he's pressing buttons and playing iTunes tracks, is what he's doing. But he's on there now. Go and have a listen to him, because you'll enjoy that, I'm sure. I don't know when I'll see you next, but if I don't see you...
Don't forget, I'm on Saturday. Tune in for that as well.
Of course, Andy's on Saturday. Don't forget. 9 o'clock, Andy?
Ish.
9 o'clock ish. On Saturday. Andy will be on. Dave's Tattle Box on Sunday. And then it's Crimble after Monday. So I'll be there on Monday night. Tune in, vape on, vape hard, and don't let the bastards grind you down. We'll see you all next time. From all of us here, take care. Cheery bye.
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 Where's the button for the... There it is.
Just there.
Yeah, I know, I've got it now. Click.
Sponsors of the Haze Hour.